All right, everybody, in here working on the 96 Grand Prix. Messed around with trying to fix the engine problem on this car. When I bought it, it was sold basically as a rough running car. Still ran and drove, had a heck of a misfire. Drove it in here into the garage, stripped most of it out now for winter. But I do want to mess around with the engine and see if I can figure out what the problem is. So I've been messing around with this for at least a day or two now. I've narrowed down to what I think it is, kind of show you my process of what I all went through, and a few other problems that I found with this car as I was doing it. First thing I did, because it was misfiring, I wanted to check all of my electrical connections, my grounds, and I wanted to check all of my vacuum lines. So I checked my grounds and my positive wires to see that they're all tightened up. First thing I noticed right off the bat, get my trusty flashlight, the ground wire to the battery that goes way down there. Two wires that are with that grounding spot, those two small wires, that small black one and that small tan one, those were both unclipped from that bolt, and the main battery cable was loose, and the nut was very loose on the end, barely holding any of those cables on. So it's amazing the car was still running, you know, with that being that loose. So I tightened that down, re-put those grounds back on there, and just to double check that all three of those are indeed ground wires, I went and looked at both of the Luminas that I own in the pole barn right now and confirmed that everything does match. So that was out of the way. Checked all of my vacuum lines, all my rubber connections. Nothing was cracked or leaking. And while the car was puttering and misfiring, I did take starting spray and sprayed it all around my vacuum lines, sprayed it all around my intake, and I could not get the engine to adjust any RPMs. So I know there's no intake leak up top with that gasket. I know there's no vacuum lines pulling anything in through that. So that fixed those three things, and the car was still misfiring when I would start it up. So the next thing I wanted to do was diagnose your three most common things in the front that are in the open. Your coil pack, your spark plug wires, and your spark plugs. I pulled the spark plugs out of the car, and they are almost all brand new. I mean, very new, nice, high-quality spark plugs. They're AC Delco spark plugs. Looks like they, definitely not the cheap version. It doesn't have a little copper tip. Has the actual, looks like a platinum tip or something up in there. And not worn down at all. Still even had the actual anti-seize thread locker compound on the threads of the spark plug. So very new, definitely recently replaced. So I knew the spark plugs weren't the problem. Put them all back in. Now I did notice upon doing that the spark plug to this cylinder here was more dirtier than the rest. So I did clean it off and put it back in place. So I started the car again, and this time I decided I was going to unplug the spark plug wires one at a time and see if I can make the car stall or stay misfiring. Now, that may sound funny to some of you, but think about it this way. It actually makes sense. If the car is already misfiring but still running, just barely, that means you probably only have one spark plug or one bad cylinder not working. If you have two cylinders or more not firing, odds are the engine will not be able to stay running and it's going to keep stalling. So I figured if I could unplug a plug wire and the engine stalled, that means I just canceled out a good spark plug that was working. Well, I started doing that, starting from this side, and the engine would stall if I pulled out those two. I went to pull this third one, and as soon as I grabbed the spark plug wire to unplug it, I got electrocuted. This whole entire plug wire was junk and was shorting out so bad that just by touching this wire, you could feel the current zapping you. So I knew right there that was one problem with this car. So I now have all brand new spark plug wires on this engine, high quality ones. I'm going to keep them for all future 3100 engines. Any W bodies will have a good spark plug set. I might even keep these spark plugs. So I fixed that issue. Started the car up, still misfiring. So we fixed several things, but still not the main issue. I'm thinking maybe now it could be one of the coil packs is bad, because I know it's not the plug wires or the spark plug. Keep in mind, I did go back to doing my tests of pulling the plug wires. I pulled the plug wire off of this one with brand new plug wires. When I did that, the car continued to misfire and did not stall. That tells me that this cylinder is the bad cylinder up here, the front right cylinder. It's the reason the car is misfiring. So I've now narrowed down my problem. I know the car has a good working fuel pump. I've heard it turn on and off. I don't know how much fuel pressure it's getting, but you would think if it was having low fuel pressure, it would affect all spark plugs and not just one. So we're going to get back to that later. So the next thing I did was to check my coil packs to see if they could be the issue. Well, I know for a fact that the Lumina I just derbied The pre-ran Lumina has a very good coil pack on it. I know for a fact those coil packs were replaced sometime in that car's life because it came from my parents. I remember it getting replaced. So I took the entire coil pack, all three of them, off the Lumina, hooked them into this engine, and put these new plug wires onto that coil pack back there. Started the car up with a good coil pack, and it still continued to misfire. So I've now diagnosed all those issues and fixed those problems. Next thing I did is I checked my oil level to see if there's anything in the oil. When I checked the oil level, it was over 2 quarts overfilled. So I now know either the previous owners overfilled it with oil, or for some reason there's something leaking into my oil. Now upon removing the oil cap here, there's no white marks on my oil cap. So, you know, if it was burning antifreeze or something, you'd think you'd have like a white buildup on there. There was no milky oil on the dipstick. I drained 2 quarts of oil out the bottom just to relieve the system and have it lowered down to where it should be. When I drained it, it came out like normal oil. It was very thin, but it was normal oil. There was no water mixed in with the oil. You'd be able to tell if there was water sloshing around with it. So that confuses me. I'm not sure, you know, if there's, I don't think there's any water going into my oil. So what I did now is I pulled out all three spark plugs again up front to re-examine them. This time I noticed that this spark plug that was previously dirty, when I pulled it out, it was soaking wet. So now I know for some reason this engine is leaking extra into the cylinder, extra something, some kind of liquid. Now, that could be two things is what I'm thinking. It could be a head gasket going bad, so therefore it's leaking antifreeze slash water into that cylinder, and it's covering the spark plug, it's making it not fire, and that's why that cylinder is going bad. The only thing that doesn't make sense is I'm not sure why there's not water in the oil if it's doing that. The other scenario is I could have a bad injector, and it could be turned all the way on, and it's just pouring fuel into that one cylinder, and it floods that cylinder out as soon as you turn the key on. And therefore, that cylinder will not fire, but all the other injectors are working. Now, if that's the case, and it is a bad injector, you have two reasons it could be bad. It could be a bad injector just because the injector itself is junk and got stuck open. Or you can have a short in the wiring system that goes to that injector or the controls to the injector, and that wire is grounding out somewhere else on this car or to the engine block, and it forces that injector to turn on. Because technically how these injectors are working, correct me if I'm wrong, guys, but I believe these injectors have power at all times, but in order to make them pulse, the computer system and the controls will ground each injector at the moment it needs to pulse. So if there's a wire that has the coating rubbed off or is shorting out and is grounding out somewhere in this engine compartment, it could be turning that injector all the way on all the time. So those are my two things, and what we're going to do right now to test this, I'm going to start this car back up with the camera on. You guys can hear it run and cough and run like crap. When it does that for a little bit, I'm going to turn it back off. I'm then going to remove this plug wire, take that spark plug out, and we should be able to see that spark plug be very wet. I'm then going to hold that spark plug back, and I'm going to take a lighter. I'm going to attempt to use the flame of the lighter on the end of that spark plug that is wet. If it lights up into flames, we know that it's gasoline that's soaking that spark plug. If that spark plug does not light up at all, then we know it's antifreeze and water that's soaking that spark plug. I don't know if you know if this is an accurate test, but I'm curious to see what will happen when I try that. So let's give it a shot right here. Alright, so as you guys just saw there, it runs pretty rough. I tried to rev it up and it maxes out around 3,000 RPMs just because of the misfire. So let's go ahead and pull that plug. As predicted, this spark plug is soaking wet, as you can see here. Let's see if it'll light. Nothing special. Still very wet on the spark plug. So that right there means this very well could be a head gasket leak that's affecting that cylinder. If it was gasoline, we should have definitely seen a poof from the fuel igniting, and instead it still remains quite moist from the water slash antifreeze that I believe is leaking onto this spark plug. Now the final check that we can do to this to confirm it takes a little bit more time, but the last thing that we can do is I can go ahead and pull the top of this intake off. I can pull off this throttle body right here. I can go ahead and check that injector, and I can swap that injector to a different cylinder, or I could take that injector completely off. Over here, I have a whole nother fuel injector rail that was an extra one that my parents had saved for their Lumina originally. And it's a very good one, low mileage one. I know it works. So I could take one of those injectors off, and I might very well pop it on this, see if it makes a difference, see if the car will run. Then, if it still misfires, I know for a fact this thing does indeed have a head gasket leak.